जीवन मुक्ति प्रदं देवं क्षमा पूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वंदे परमहं साख्यं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं जीवन मुक्ति प्रदं देवं क्षमा पूर्णं जगद्गुरुं वंदे परमहं साख्यं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं आनंदानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वंदे पाप विनाशकं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं आनंदानुभवास्वादं सर्वरोगनिवारकं वंदे पाप विनाशकं नित्यानंदाय स्वागतं नित्यमुक्तं निर्विकल्पं ध्यानलोक प्रदीपकं
परमहंस नित्यानंद ఈ శతాబ్దపు మరువలేని పోలికలేని ఒక ఆధ్యాత్మిక శక్తి ఒక అంతర్జాతీయ సాంఘిక ఆధ్యాత్మిక ప్రబంజనాన్ని స్థాపించిన ఒక అద్భుత శక్తి వైదిక ధర్మాన్ని పునరుద్ధరించడానికి ఉద్భవించిన ఒక చైతన్య శక్తి ఆయన అతి పవిత్రమైన తిరువన్నామలై క్షేత్రంలో జన్మించారు ఒక యోగిగా జన్మించి తనలో సహజంగానే పొంగిపొరలే ఆధ్యాత్మికతను కోట్ల మందికి పంచుతూ స్ఫూర్తినిచ్చే ఒక అమోఘ శక్తి అతి పురాతనమైన యోగా విద్యలో ప్రావీణ్యం కలిగి ఆధ్యాత్మిక శాస్త్రాన్ని క్షుణ్ణంగా పరిశోధన చేసిన ఒక మహాద్భుతమైన అంతఃప్రపంచపు పరిశోధకులు ఆత్మజ్ఞానాన్ని ప్రసాదించే గురువులు ప్రతి సంవత్సరం పరమహంస నిత్యానంద ఆయన జ్ఞానామృతాన్ని ఆనందం వెదజల్లే ఆయన చిరునవ్వుని తిరుగులేని ఆయన దీక్ష యొక్క శక్తిని ఒక కోటికి పైగా ఉన్న ఆయన శిష్యులకు పంచుతున్నారు ఇప్పుడు పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మీరు జీవన్ముక్తులుగా జీవించడానికి తోడ్పడే పరిష్కారాలను మీకు అందజేస్తున్నారు ఒక మరువలేని ఆధ్యాత్మిక అనుభవం కొరకు మమ్మల్ని వెంటనే సంప్రదించండి
వేద వేదాంత సంవేద్యం దేవ దేవీ స్వరూపిణం వందే వటపలాశిస్థం
యదా హి ధర్మస్య గ్లానిహి భవతి భారతః అభ్యుద్ధానమధర్మస్య తదాత్మానం సృజామ్యహం O Bharat, as and when you forget techniques, tools, lifestyle, space and method, knowledge of living enlightenment and tend to get into the lifestyle of unconsciousness, chaos in all such situations I create myself with form and I happen
you may think how it's a very Only if you read between lines, you'll be able to understand. This technique is used even by Zen masters. When first this understanding was given to you, you may have Margada Vairagya. Means for 5-6 minutes, you'll contemplate. Yes, true. Right, you see. All these fellows, they run around, finally break the body, nothing else. What is the achievement? You may make lakhs of crores swindling the country, destroy all your enemies, and collect all the wealth only for your family. Have one wife in every street. Finally, what will happen? You will die. Maybe somebody will keep a statue for you as a toilet for crows in the Marina Beach. Nothing else. You will start contemplating. You will start thinking. That Margada Vairagya period, those few seconds, if a part is broken on your head, that hit will make that Vairagya, see that those few moments of Vairagya, and non-mechanical parts of your brain gets awakened. Understand? Whenever you think any high-level thought, one non-mechanical component, non-mechanical part of your brain gets awakened. It's a truth. Any higher truth you contemplate or clicks with you, a non-mechanical parts of the brain gets awakened. So when you are having that markada vairagya, that few second vairagya, the feeling, oh God, if a pot is broken on your head, literally the mud pot has to be broken on your head, that shake, that shock makes that non-mechanical part of the brain awakened for a long time. The markada vairagya will become garbhagala vairagya. Please understand, this is the mystical process embedded in each Siddha songs. Zen use this technique. They use a stick. If a disciple comes and a master says something, and if it clicks to the disciple, the master immediately will take the stick and beat him exactly on the sahasrara, on that crown part. Tuck. You may think, what inhuman activity. It's a technique. Even Osho used it. You'll be surprised. Person like Osho, such a sophisticated master, using a stick and beating a disciple, used it. There are enough of records. Close disciples, he'll give them some click. The moment it clicks, he'll take the stick and hit on the sahasrara. The shock, the non-mechanical parts of the brain which is awakened, stays awakened. That vairagya gets established, embedded. And the second thing, if you have a garbhagala vairagya, to make that into maranagala vairagya, if you keep the part on the head and break that part with another one part, means a very subtle shock needs to be given to the body. It's a very evolved process. I am describing it so that you understand how in every Siddha verse the three layers are embedded in one line, just to reveal. I'll prove the power of this process. I'll break a mud pot, and somebody said, and show how the non-mechanical parts awakened stays permanently awakened. We will do all these things. We will prove all these things through the medical research, through the scientific research. See, for example, if you click with the idea of boundarylessness, what is boundary? How can you say you end in this, where your skin ends? No. Because the life which goes inside you and comes out of you, which constantly keeps this living itself, is boundaryless prana, air. If you say this is your boundary, then seal it. Come on, seal it and live with yourself. You can't. So the very life with which you feel boundary is from boundarylessness. So how can you say you have a boundary? No. Something which is beyond boundary is just automatically moving inside and keeping, which considers itself with boundary alive, and it comes out by itself. Something is going on. In that whole chaos, you catch a small place and you say, my boundary. When during the rainy season, these kids will make boats out of paper and play outside the house. And if the other kid's boat comes inside this boundary, they'll say, hey, it's my boat. It's my boundary. They will grab that boat. So how in the vast stream of water, these kids claim small part as their boundary. When you look at that, it looks foolish. But you do the same thing. In this vast number of bodies, you catch this, oh, it's my boundary. And if anything comes here, the paper boat, it's mine. Means the money. Money is the paper boat. People make and leave, goes on. Any paper boat comes inside my boundary, it is mine. Grab it and put it in your bank account, and bankruptcy. Suddenly your money is not there. Why the money is not there? They say the global economic crisis.
Kalpataru. మీ జీవితం నుంచి మానసిక ఒత్తిడిని దూరం చేసుకోండి. మీ పనితనాన్ని మెరుగుపరుచుకోండి. మీ తెలివితేటలని, నిర్ణయాలు తీసుకున్నటకు తోడ్పడే వివేకాన్ని పెంచుకోండి. కల్పతరు ఒక విశిష్టమైన ఒక్కరోజు కార్యక్రమం. అవతార పురుషులైన పరమహంస నిత్యానంద స్వామి వారి హీలింగ్ మరియు దీవెనలను అందుకునే ఒక అద్భుత అవకాశం. ప్రతి వారాంతములో కల్పతరు కార్యక్రమం బిడిది ఆశ్రమంలో నిర్వహించబడును. మమ్మల్ని సంప్రదించవలసిన చిరునామా నిత్యానంద ధ్యానపీఠం, నిత్యానంద నగర్, బిడది 562109, బెంగళూరు. ఫోన్ చేయవలసిన నంబరు 09555000550, లేదా 09618 1901. మా వెబ్సైట్ www.nityananda.org.
सहस्रशो वै शादुं हेडयीमहे असव्यो वसत्पति नीलग्रीवो विलोहितः उदैनं कोपा
understand this boundarylessness, one part of your brain, which is non-mechanical part of your brain, gets awakened, just a part below the parietal lobe and above the neck. That's the area I was experimenting. Last few days I am sitting and contemplating, scanning. I take up every concept and see when this becomes reality, which part of the brain, which non-mechanical part of the brain gets alive. Because in my case, all completely alive. I do not know which one awakens which one. So I'll have to shut down everything and get back and then bring that one idea. What happens? Bring the next idea. What happens? This is the way I was scanning. So we'll prove it scientifically. The boundarylessness idea is given to you. The part below the parietal lobe and above the neck, that is the area, lights up. And I'll prove this first. Next thing, when that part lights up on that person's head, I'll break apart and prove that subtle shock how makes that non-mechanical part awakened permanently for a longer period. This is the first. Second, if a part is kept and that part is broken by another one part, then it is a subtlest shock. See, these are all the techniques used by Siddhas to keep that non-mechanical part awakened eternally. Siddhas were doers. They are not just Vedantis, metaphysics, metaphysical conceptualist, Mayavadi, illusionist theories. No, they are doers. They make it happen. If a part is kept and that part is broken by the another one part, then more subtlest vibration is sent inside the body. I have seen this Raghupati Yogi. He will do this game. He will, there is a herb called Trinithpatrini, a simple ordinary village herb which is used for puja and all. You will get that and tell the disciples to keep it in the between the teeth and go on breaking coconut on the head. I have seen nothing will happen to the head, only the coconuts will be broken. And the funny thing is, very shocking thing is, if somebody does not levitate, he will do this only, and then that fellow will start levitating. But the siddhas have their own method, technique. So the essence of today's message is, whatever siddhas are using is a great science, and all their verses have a layers and layers of deeper and deeper and deeper different level meanings. Understand, anything a siddha does has meaning, including beating. If you are fortunate enough to be in the surrender mood, even a simple beating can awaken some parts of your system, non-mechanical parts of your brain, forever. Siddhis, the extraordinary science beyond psychic powers. Psychic powers are more like a mind over the matter. Siddhis are like a consciousness over consciousness. It is not an ordinary. So understand, siddhas, siddha purushas, their actions should not be measured by our ordinary intellect. Their experiences should not be measured by our ordinary mind. It has to be dived, delved, meditated, contemplated, and experienced.
ఒక అవతార పురుషుని దివ్య సలహాను నేరుగా పొందాలనుకుంటున్నారా? ఇప్పుడు మీకు పరమహంసతో ముఖాముఖి.
నిత్యానందం, నిత్యానంద హియర్.
పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మరొక్కసారి పోలిక లేని ఒక విభిన్నమైన కానుకను ప్రపంచానికి అందజేస్తున్నారు. ఆయన ఇప్పుడు ప్రతిరోజు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారమయ్యే సత్సంగంలో మీ ప్రశ్నలకి జవాబు ఇవ్వడానికి సిద్ధముగా ఉన్నారు. ఉదయం 8 గంటలకు మా నంబరు 0807-272-9999కి ఫోన్ చేసే అదృష్టవంతులకు ఆయనతో నేరుగా మాట్లాడే దివ్యమైన అవకాశం దక్కుతుంది. మరియు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారమయ్యే సత్సంగం ntv.nityananda.org చూడగలరు.
దాసాం అనాదిత్వం చ ఆశిషో నిత్యత్వాత్. ప్లీజ్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఫ్యూ థింగ్స్. జస్ట్ లైక్ కంట్రీ ఫంక్షన్స్ విత్ సర్టైన్ లాస్, కాస్మాస్ ఫంక్షన్స్ విత్ సర్టైన్ లాస్. నాట్ నోయింగ్ ద లా ఆఫ్ ద కంట్రీ కెనాట్ బి అన్ ఎక్స్క్యూజ్ ఫార్ యూ నాట్ ఫాలోయింగ్ ద లాస్. Whether you know it or not, the laws of the country binds you. You are expected to know the laws and abide by the laws. Same way, not knowing the laws of the cosmos cannot be the excuse to escape from those laws. Every human being happened in the planet Earth is expected to know the laws of the cosmos and align the life in tune with the law of the cosmos. Please understand, if you know the law of the country and align yourself with that law and express your creativity, not only you will create wealth, the country's infrastructure will support you to live blissfully. If you are not aligning yourself with the law, naturally unexpected calamities. Same way with the cosmic law, know the law, align yourself, the whole cosmos will support you. You are the ambition of cosmos. Your fulfillment is a joint venture between you and cosmos. Please understand. Your fulfillment is not just your responsibility. The whole universe, you may call it God, Shiva, Krishna, Rama, now Venkateshwara, whatever name you may use, but the whole cosmos is waiting to fulfill itself through you. So your ambition is the ambition of the cosmos. The biggest problem is when you do not know the laws of the cosmos, when you are not interested in aligning with the cosmos, the universe tries to align you. That is what you call as punishment. It is not. It is the signals sent to you by the universe to align yourself, to get back to the center, to get back to the source, to get back to the functioning. Please understand, law of the cosmos is what we call law of karma. The word karma should be understood from all its multi-dimension, as a noun, as a verb, as a mystical system, as a functioning method. In every dimension, in every aspect, when the idea karma is understood, automatically, naturally, you experience life much more alive, much more positive, much more experiential, much more centered. Karma is not just the simple theory which you learn from in the household. Oh, if you do good, good will happen. If you do bad, bad will happen. It is only an introduction to the karma theory. Unfortunately, we stop with the introduction. We don't explore the deeper possibilities. By and by, talking, telling others, you yourself will get confused. What all the 10 I really have and what all the 15 I added? You are in a big mess. The personality confusion. Please understand, I am using a new word. Personality confusion starts from your hypocrisy. When you start adding things just to sell yourself, by and by you forget what you added and what is your original capacities, capability. Being clear about your capability and about the things which you can't do raises the spectrum of your consciousness. You start living in a different space. I tell you, just this one clarity, knowing what you can do and knowing what you can't do, and aligning all your word, action and planning with that, I can say as a basic understanding about karma.
Kalpataru, మీలోని కుండలినీ శక్తిని తెలుసుకోగల ఒక ప్రత్యేక కార్యక్రమము కల్పతరు. పూర్తిగా ఒకరోజు జరిగే ఈ కార్యక్రమములో ఆరోగ్యకరమైన అద్భుతమైన మార్పును పొందగలరు. అవతారమూర్తి పరమహంస నిత్యానంద స్వామివారి ఆశీస్సులను ప్రత్యేకంగా పొందగల కార్యక్రమం కల్పతరు. కుండలిని అంటే ఏమిటి? కుండలిని అంటే ప్రతి ఒక్కరిలోనూ దాగి ఉన్న అద్భుత శక్తి. కుండలిని శక్తి ఒక ధ్యానోదయమైన గురుదేవుల దీక్షతో చైతన్యపరచవచ్చు. ఈ కుండలిని శక్తి మీ జీవితంలో అన్ని దశలలోనూ అభివృద్ధికరమైన మార్పులను తేగలిగే శక్తి. అది మీలో ఆరోగ్యాన్ని, ఐశ్వర్యాన్ని, విజయాన్ని, ఆనందాన్ని, ఆధ్యాత్మిక ధ్యానోదయాన్ని కలిగిస్తుంది. ప్రతి వారాంతములో కల్పతరు కార్యక్రమం బిడిది ఆశ్రమంలో నిర్వహించబడును. మమ్మల్ని సంప్రదించవలసిన చిరునామా నిత్యానంద ధ్యానపీఠం, నిత్యానంద నగర్, బిడది 562109 బెంగళూరు. ఫోన్ చేయవలసిన నంబరు 09555000550 లేదా 09618519701. మా వెబ్సైట్ www.nityananda.org.
Second sacred secret you need to know about karma is the actions which you perform does not come back to your life as a quantity of the actions you performed. No, but the quality of the attitude you picked it up. Please understand. For example, somebody is continuously stealing. As per the cosmic law, you are not going to get the punishment based on the amount you stole, but the punishment is going to be based on the lifestyle, means the habit of stealing built in your system. When the habit gets built, when the attitude gets built, naturally the unconscious mental setup you accumulate leads you to deeper and deeper problems. Let me tell you a small story. On a tree, one thief was sitting, and whoever is crossing through that area, he was throwing stones on them. It's a remote area, forest area. Whoever is walking in that way, he was throwing stones. One sadhu was walking that way, and this thief, he threw a stone on the sadhu. Sadhu, he just looked up and said, "Be blissful," and went away. He did not get angry. Then the thief started thinking, "Oh, if you throw stones at people, they will bless you." Next came a king. This guy repeated the same thing. Now you know what would have happened. Not only he was beaten, and he was imprisoned. So it is the attitude which he built up by the actions brought problem to him. Karma brings results in your life more because of the quality it adds to your consciousness than the quantity of the action. See, the country law measures the quantity of the action. For example, when you steal, as per the country law, they will give the punishment based on the quantity of the stealing. What you stole, what is the worth of it? With the law of the universe, you merge with the Lord of the universe. Take this one great truth and do samyama. Now, law of cosmic law is waiting to fulfill you. Your life is a joint venture between you and cosmic law. Universe, cosmos is not your enemy. It is waiting to feel fulfilled through you. All you need is understanding about cosmic law. Sit and contemplate, meditate. How I can understand cosmic law? How I can make myself available to cosmic law? How more I can be in tune with the cosmic law? You don't need to find out a technique or method. Even if you create a will that let me be in tune with the cosmic law, you open up to the universe and universe opens itself to you. Just sit and contemplate, create a will. Let me be connected with this whole universe, the whole cosmic law. Let the universe experience itself through me. Let me experience universe in me. Let me be fulfilled in the physical health or mental health or wealth or the spiritual enlightenment or in relationships. In all dimensions, let the fulfillment of the cosmos, universe, be experienced in me. Let me experience fulfillment in the universe. Just contemplate this one idea in you. Feel, let you all experience the fulfillment in all dimensions in you. Just create strong will to connect with the cosmic law, with the universal law, with the truth of karma, with the sacred secrets of karma.